Hey, you're listening to Phil DeBella, and this is Flashcast by PDB. And today, one thing I really want to talk about is listening to understand versus listening to respond. So let me say that again. It's one of the most powerful things I've learned in 2020, and it is the ability for people to listen to understand versus listening to respond. And it's something that if you watch closely or if you're having a bit of an aha moment, you'll see that often when conversations go bad or relationships, you know, have a bit of a dip in the road, it's because people are not listening to understand. They're actually listening to respond, or you're not feeling like you're being heard. So I want to touch on this topic today and explore it further. So firstly, what is listening to understand? What does it look like? Well, it's instead of thinking about what you want to say while the person is talking, it's actually about really listening to them. So whilst they're listening, it's all about you trying to understand what they're saying, not thinking in your head what you want to respond with. And we're all guilty of it. And myself, my brain works pretty quick. My number one strength is problem solving. So I'm guilty of this many times where I'll actually be working on a response while they're talking. And it's not because I'm not actually trying to understand. And don't get me wrong, I get it wrong at times. But I've got to be very conscious of this because perception is reality. And at times I can come across as if I'm listening to respond versus listening to understand. Now, it's because my brain works very quickly. And in terms of my number one strength, it's problem solving. So as the person's talking, I'm processing the information and I'm understanding it and I'm building a response in my head or a solution to their problem as they're talking. But again, I have to be very careful of this because at times I can come across like I'm actually listening to respond versus listening to understand. So using myself as an example, this is something that I've had to become very, very aware of because again, perception is reality and we all want to be understood. Firstly, we all want to be listened to and then we want to be listened to understand versus listening to respond. And it's very, very important. Now, of course, the benefits of listening is all about developing patience, tolerance, you know, and again, this is something I've been guilty over the years and I constantly work on is that a good listener actually has great patience and tolerance. And my wife, Jana, she is amazing at this. She's a great listener because she is patient. She's tolerable. She listens, she understands, she analyzes, then she responds. And I've learned some really good traits by listening, you know, actually listening to her and how she goes about it because she's very, very good about this. But it's very important to listen. You know, it's the ability to accurately receive and interpret messages before you actually communicate back. And as I say, the communication is a common denominator of failure. And therefore, if we're not listening to understand and we're not accurately receiving and then interpreting that message, how can we possibly communicate effectively back? So to be an effective communicator, it all starts with the ability to listen to understand. And that is something that's really, really, really important. And for people to really, you know, understand themselves on what type of listener they are. Now, how can you listen without responding? Well, if you're the listener, don't respond at all for say 2 minutes. You know, I try and use the 30-second rule, you know, 30-second pause and go. But, you know, the common theme is for people to sit between that 30-second and 2 minutes to really, you know, understand, you know, using facial expressions, nodding your head. Eye contact is so, so important to show people that you are, you know, actually listening. The eye contact is important. You know, you watch somebody's eyes when you're talking and it'll really say something about them. Are they listening to understand or are they listening to respond? You know, so being, you know, actively a good listener is all about that eye contact. It's about using, you know, nonverbal gestures such as nodding your head, you know, your facial expression, really, really important. These are things that will show people that you are actually an active listener. You know, it's really important for us to understand that as an active listener, what we're doing is we're actually showing comfort. We're emotionally engaging with somebody. You know, that when you're an active listener, that a person feels engaged with you because they feel that they can share with you. They feel that you're actually understanding them. So a couple of tips is to practice, you know, practice this with friends, and practice is all about being conscious, you know, being conscious in a moment in a conversation and saying, right, I'm going to practice right now. I'm going to practice to not respond for 30 seconds. I'm going to practice to make sure that I'm fully engaged with eye contact. I'm going to practice with, you know, nonverbal reactions with my face, with my nodding. Practice it, you know. The next thing is to be open-minded. You know, you need to be open-minded and accepting. So open-mindedness, mindfulness is so, so important. And mindedness comes from being, you know, mindful. You need to be there. You need to be present. If you're not present, your subconscious will take you in a different direction. And often what will happen is that you won't be there. So some of the questions to ask yourself, can I stay fully present and listen deeply? Can I keep from judging what another person is saying? And we've all been there. That judgment doesn't allow people to emotionally engage with you. Can I refrain from offering advice? My experience in YPO, you know, Young Presidents Organization, over the last 11, 12 years has really helped me with this, where we can only offer advice if the other person feels welcomes the advice. Otherwise, it has to come from experience. It can't be advice based on opinions. It can't be judgmental advice. It's got to actually be advice coming from an experience that you've had. Unless, of course, you've given permission from the person communicating that they want your opinion. And another one is, can I avoid from interpreting this person's experience, right? And this is something that we really need to understand. Can I avoid from interpreting? So making assumptions is so, so dangerous. We need to make sure that we're not making assumptions, asking clarifying questions. So somebody that listens actively is obviously present with their eyes, present. They're non-talking, they're non-verbals, but they're also not judging you. They're not making assumptions. They're asking clarifying questions to understand where you're coming from better, right? And this will all help you be attentive. You know, you also need to listen to the words, but listen to the silence. You know, silence speaks very, very, you know, great words, let's say. Silence is a great way to see, you know, how does it feel in that moment of silence? Is it a moment of compassion, emotionally engaging, or is it a moment of uncomfortableness? Because there are differences. So these are all things about, you know, active listening. So, but what I want to cover off and finish on is some traits of good listeners. You know, when I look at people like my wife, you read books on Gandhi, all people that were great listeners, Mandela, you have a look at, you know, at their traits, and you'll start to see some of these come through. Well, and this is what I've seen, is that one, they're fully present. So a good listener is present. You know, their eyes aren't darting all around the room and looking past you and seeing what's going on. You know, they're really, really actively present in what you're saying. They're not listening to respond. You know, you don't see their mouth trying to start to open a talk before you've even finished. You know, they're actually listening, engaging, processing, analyzing. They react in the moment. Right. So what I mean by that is that they understand what you're saying, they've analyzed it, and then they come back to you in that moment, right? The moment right there of what's happening then and there. And in the moment means about directly responding to what you're talking about, not taking you down a rabbit hole of another discussion or bringing up other things, but actually addressing in the moment what you are talking to them about. Another one is that they don't have any hidden agendas. So they're not using what you're trying to say to them as an opportunity to launch into something else. Right? Which flows into they don't just give advice, right? They give advice based on experience, or they ask open, or they make suggestions rather than an opinion, rather than a judgment, you know? And this is where we all feel funny, you know, rightly or wrongly, we all get funny when people are starting to judge us. And then the last one that I really noticed, and this is something that I learned from my dad when I was growing up, is they may talk a lot themselves, but they do a lot. So they might talk a lot, but they actually do. And if you spin that around, they actually listen more than what they speak. So think about that. My dad always said, it's okay to talk a lot as long as you do more than what you talk. Now, it comes the same. It's okay to talk a lot as long as you listen more than what you talk. So that's something that really has stayed with me. Now, in closing, great listeners make good humans. Good humans become great, good at communicators. You can't be a great communicator if you're not somebody who listens to understand versus listening to respond. So next time you're in that deep conversation with someone, or just having a conversation in general, whether it's small talk at a party, or whether it's a deep conversation, or whether it's a personal, professional conversation, or even if it's a conversation with yourself, make sure that you're listening to understand. Make sure that you're not listening to respond. Make sure that you're in that moment, that you're non-judgmental, that you are taking that 30 seconds to say, hey, I'm listening, I'm analyzing, I'm absorbing, and then I'm going to respond in the moment and be attentive to what you have to say. I hope you've enjoyed this flashcast. It's something that is dear to me, and something that I constantly work on and need to work on, is to listen to understand versus to listening to respond. You've been listening to Phil DeBella, and this is Flashcast by PDB. And until next time, you go be the best you can be.